So, regardless of how long you've been running, becoming a faster runner is a universal goal. After all, you can't let every single person overtake you now, can you? Now, getting faster is not really all that difficult, and what I mean by that is, in case you're already a runner, you don't really have to increase your mileage by a lot, but instead, structure every single workout of yours more efficiently. In other words, every single workout of yours needs to solve a purpose. So, what are these purposes I'm talking about? First, make your easy runs way easier. So, typically, you have your three runs, your easy runs, your long runs, and your hard runs. The first thing you have to do is take your easy runs and make them way easier. On a scale of 1 to 10, that should be at a 5 or someplace where you can hold a conversation while running. Now, this speed. When done right, is going to be just above your warm-up speed and it's going to feel too slow because it is. So without getting too technical, what this does is basically keeps you approximately between 60 and 75% of your maximum heart rate, and this is the sweet spot. This is where you want to run. This sweet zone is where you get the maximal amount of benefits for the least amount of effort, therefore keeping your recovery times lower. Ironically, it is running fast all the time that does not actually make you faster, and if you make your easy runs any faster than they need to be, you need a lot more recovery, which makes it very difficult to speed up. Remember, you speed up by recovering right, not by exercising a lot. Which brings me to my next point, progressive overload, or basically how you handle your volume. To explain simply, if your goal is to run 100 kilometers this month, instead of spreading it out evenly, that is running 25 kilometers every week for 4 weeks, you can instead spread it out somewhere like 20 kilometers the first week, 30 kilometers the next week, 35 after that, followed by a week of recovery, so only 15 kilometers. What this does is gives you an upwards progression, so an upwards increase in load followed by a week of recovery. This upwards increase in your load will let your body adapt to the increase in the load followed by a week of recovery, so you can actually improve. After this, your monthly goal of 100 kilometers can increase to 110 kilometers and just repeat. So you don't necessarily have to run a lot more kilometers. All you have to do is take your current kilometers and run them in a progressive manner. And if you've learned something new in this video, be sure to subscribe to Coffee Shop to learn more and become a better athlete. And to the final point, recover better. Now, making your easy runs easier and progressively overloading kind of helps this point to shine. It's from a very famous protocol known as the 80-20 training method, where you do 80% of your training easy and 20% of it hard. As I said, you speed up by recovering correctly. If your easy runs are any harder than they need to be, you will get a marginal amount of additional benefit while your recovery time will increase by a lot. Similarly, if you have to run 100 kilometers this month, progressively overloading that will help your body adapt better, while also giving you a week to make sure that you recover. These are great ways to just reduce the amount of recovery you need while also giving you additional time to recover. Now, while you're in recovery, nothing is ever going to beat sleeping more, sleeping better, and eating right. Do these three things correctly and you are always going to be able to pound your body for all the workouts that you're going to be doing. And that's about it. Follow these three principles and you will see yourself getting fast, really fast, while also possibly working out the same or even lesser than you were before. If you want to learn more about recovery, I've already made a bunch of videos on that. Do check those out. A sub to my channel would be spectacular, and I'll see you very soon.